Our money man, Kelly Brothers, and we got to start with this. We just announced S&P's president stepping down after that downgrade of the credit system here. What do you think has an impact maybe? How is this all going to affect the big picture?
Well, Kelly, I think our tendency is to say, wow, it was only a few weeks ago that S&P downgraded the United States, which was an unprecedented move. And could this be somehow related to that? And it might be, very well could be. Devin Sharma stepping down to look at, quote unquote, other challenges. But I think this might have more to do with the fact that the Justice Department is actually investigating S&P to see if dozens of mortgage-related securities were improperly rated during the financial crisis of 08. Actually, we know they were improperly rated. The question is, was there anything illegal done which prevented them from being rated properly? Let's take a look at the real-time numbers this morning, because despite the fact we're still headed for the worst August since 1998, we're in positive territory this morning. Dow up about 48 points on the back of good manufacturing data out of Germany. NASDAQ is up 12. The S&P is up almost 3 points. But it is kind of the long shadow of 2008. Not only do you have S&P and their CEO stepping down, that may have something to do with that Justice Department investigation, but also a word from Goldman Sachs yesterday that their CEO has hired a prominent defense attorney. That has to do with another investigation with Goldman Sachs' actions during that financial crisis of 08. So the reverberation still being felt from all that went on three and a half years ago. Guys, back to you.
And this was the organization that gave, I believe, Enron a positive rating prior to the debacle that became Enron, right?
Oh, S&P. Yeah, well, there were a lot of things that were misrated. There's right. No doubt about it. I mean, they basically, you got a bunch of subprime mortgages and they put a wrapper around it and called it, you know, good paper or investment grade paper in some cases. So there were a lot of mistakes made. The question is, could they have known that things were wrong, or was it just a case of them not doing proper due diligence in their homework to find out the actual rating mm-hmm. of those securities?
All right. Kelly Brothers, thank you as always.
All righty.